Welcome back! In the last lesson, we learned how to perform sequences of transformations and use coordinate notation to represent them. But let's say we're only given the pre-image and the image of a sequence. We only know how we started and how we ended. There is more than one sequence that the pre-image could have taken to become the image. Mia may have rotated 90 degrees clockwise around the origin and then reflected over the y-axis. Or Mia may have rotated 90 degrees counterclockwise around the origin and then reflected over the x-axis. Today, you're going to learn how to find these sequences of transformations between pre-images and images. Let's look at this example. We want to identify a sequence of transformations between the pre-image and image and represent it using coordinate notation. To determine what transformations took place, let's first ask ourselves, did the orientation change? Are their sides and vertices arranged the same way? The sides and vertices are in the same places on the image as they were on the pre-image. The pre-image did not flip or turn, so the orientation did not change. This means only translations took place in this sequence. The points only shifted or slid from one place to another. Counting the boxes, the pre-image could have first translated left 7 units. The coordinate notation that describes this translation is x minus 7, y. Then, the pre-image would have translated up 6 units to complete the sequence. That translation increases the new y-coordinate by 6. The single coordinate notation describing the entire sequence will be x minus 7, y plus 6. What's another possible sequence of transformations that could work here? The pre-image could have translated up 6 units first, which is x, y plus 6, followed by a translation left 7 units, which decreases the x-coordinate by 7. The single coordinate notation describing the entire sequence would be x minus 7, y plus 6. Whoa, the coordinate notations of both sequences are the same. No matter how we chose to get from the pre-image to the image, the steps we took simplified to create the same coordinate notation. But both of these sequences did only involve translations. What about for sequences with reflections or rotations? Will different approaches still simplify to the same coordinate notations? Let's look at an example. Comparing the pre-image and image, did the orientation change? Comparing their sides and vertices, we can see that the orientation changed. The image is a turned version of the pre-image. What type of rotation would have made this happen? This pre-image could have turned right once, which is a 90-degree clockwise rotation, or it could have turned left 3 times, a 270-degree counterclockwise rotation. And here's their coordinate notation. Let's see where exactly this first transformation would take this pre-image. That will help us visualize what we need to do next to get it to its final destination. Go ahead and perform this rotation and sketch in R prime, S prime, and Q prime. Pause the video now. This will be the image after the rotation. Now that we can see this in-between step, what else do we need to do to get the final image? What is the second transformation we can take? Yeah, we need a translation 3 units right, creating QRS double prime. The translation 3 units right is represented by x plus 3 comma y. Now let's write the single coordinate notation that describes this sequence. The rotation has switched the x and y and changed the sign of the x. The translation increased the new x coordinate, y, by 3 and did not affect the new y coordinate. The coordinate notation describing this entire sequence is y plus 3 comma negative x. Let's check whether our coordinate notation is correct by applying it to point Q at 4 comma 5. We switch 4 and 5, change the sign of 4 to negative 4, and add 3 to 5. This gives us Q double prime at 8 comma negative 4. Which matches the coordinates of Q double prime. Nice! What's another possible two-step sequence? Maybe we could translate first and then rotate it. But if we're going to translate it first, where exactly should we translate it to? Maybe we can work backward to see where this shape would need to be before rotating into its final position. To find where QRS double prime was before that rotation, we need to go back in time by rotating it in the opposite direction, a 90 degree counterclockwise rotation. Using any method of your choice, pause now to perform that rotation. I'm going to use the rectangle method here. I'll first draw a rectangle from the origin to point Q, then rotate that rectangle 90 degrees counterclockwise, giving us Q prime. I'll do the same with point R. And finally, point S. With our prime points, we can create triangle QRS prime. This is where the image was before it rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Now that we know where QRS prime was in this sequence, what translation needed to happen first? Our pre-image needed to be translated up 3 units. That means our sequence will be a translation 3 units up, followed by a 90 degree clockwise or 270 degree counterclockwise rotation around the origin. Take a moment to pause and write the single coordinate notation that describes this sequence. Pause now. The rotation switches x and y plus 3 and then changes the sign of x. The coordinate notation for the sequence is y plus 3 comma negative x. It may seem like we just switched the order of the transformations, but taking a closer look, we translated right 3 units in the first sequence and up 3 units in the second sequence. The translations are in different directions and their individual coordinate notations are also different. Although we used different transformations in each of these sequences, the final coordinate notation still simplified to be the same. Awesome! I think you're ready to try one on your own. Comparing the pre-image and image, we can see that the orientation changed. The sides and vertices are arranged differently. Did the pre-image reflect or rotate? Looking closer, we can see that the image is a flipped version of the pre-image, meaning there must be a reflection in the sequence. Go ahead and identify a sequence of transformations between the pre-image and image, where reflection is the first step. Use the spaces provided in your guided notes and the coordinate plane. Pause now and come back once you're done. A sequence where reflection is the first step would start with a reflection over the y-axis. Its orientation matches that of the image now, but we still need to complete the sequence. You probably realize that we need two translations here. We can do a translation 4 units down, followed by a translation right 1 unit, or a translation right 1 unit, then a translation 4 units down. Regardless of the order, the coordinate notation would be x plus 1 comma y minus 4. Now that we have our sequence, let's represent it with a single coordinate notation. Pause now to write it and come back once you're ready. The x coordinate after the reflection is negative x, and the translation increases the new x coordinate by 1. The y coordinate doesn't change after the reflection, and the translation decreases it by 4. And that's the coordinate notation representing this sequence. Let's check whether it's correct by applying it to a random point. Using point M at negative 5, negative 2, we change the sign of negative 5 to 5 and add 1, then subtract the negative 2 by 4. That gives us 6, negative 6, which matches M double prime. Now let's say we want to find another sequence that works, but this time, the reflection over the y-axis is the last step. Find a sequence where a reflection over the y-axis was the last step. If a reflection over the y-axis was the last step, we need to reflect our image back over the y-axis to find MNOP prime, which is where the image was before the reflection. We can translate our pre-image sequence down 4 units and left 1 unit, or left 1 unit and down 4 units. Here's our coordinate notation for that translation. From our previous examples, we observed that even if we found 2 different sequences to take us from the pre-image to the image, as long as we simplify what we did accurately, we'll get the same coordinate notation. So in this sequence, we should get the same coordinate notation as the previous one. The x coordinate after the translation is x minus 1, and the reflection turns this new x coordinate into its opposite. The y coordinate after the translation is y minus 4, and the reflection doesn't change it. Using the distributive property, we simplify the x-coordinate into negative x plus 1. And like we had predicted, the coordinate notations are identical. You've made it to the end of this unit. Fantastic job learning the different transformations and putting them all together. It's time to apply what you've learned today to some practice levels. And remember, math is everywhere. Keep exploring. Hey, hey.